start tonight with a survey. By a show of hands, who here tonight was part of the focus group that resulted in FedEx feeling it necessary to write ground on that truck with wheels and air on that plane? Slapshot hat. One of the great stories of all time, and this is the perfect month for it, Remembrance Day month. My first cousin, John, was in the Canadian Armed Forces. And let's hear it for the forces. So John was sharing a house with three other guys. And a true story, and often the true stories are the funniest. So I was sharing a house with three other guys, and one of the guys had a month leave, and he went back to his home in St. John's, Newfoundland. And in the house that they were living, they had, like everyone here has, the super mailbox. So, Fred, stop pulling that plug every second. Is it back on? All right. So, the super mailbox, so they call him up in Newfoundland. He has the key to get their mail. So they say, hey man, we can't live without our mail for a month. So he did the right thing. He mailed them the key. And those of you from Newfoundland who's thinking, why is that funny? Now the key is in the box with a true story. My cousin says, no wonder there's so many jokes. My buddy Fred, and I'm not going to break any confidence here because this part they've talked about on the radio, but Freddie has an affinity to answer Donald Trump's tweets. Okay. And he didn't realize, but Donald Trump has the ability to put anyone on the no-fly list. But Fred thinks that he's the only one affected. However, when you Google, there's 283 Fred Pattersons in the English-speaking world outside of the United States. So on the no-fly list now, Freddie, because of his answers to these tweets, Donald Trump tweets, many people booed the players, NFL, who kneeled yesterday. These are fans who demand respect for the flag. So Freddie writes in response, oh, fuck off, you pea-brained idiot. Get to work and do something useful, like quitting. Fred Pattersons are no longer allowed in the United States because of my buddy. The NASCAR one was even better. NASCAR fans, they respect the flag. So Freddie writes, NASCAR is full of goobers. Goofy, dumbass, yank goobers. Not surprised you side with them, you fucker. Hey Fred, I like NASCAR. Thank you for coming out. Get your Johnny Slapshot hat. And Howard, thank you. Oh, very good.